Good evening, I'm Nicholas Hoare. The New York Times has finally decided to anthologize its huge archive of articles on wine. And the result is this thumper of a book called, inevitably, The New York Times Book of Wine. It represents 30 years of work on the part of its various and very seasoned contributors, and it's extremely handsomely put together. It's broken up by subject matter, it is very well curated, and it's one of those nice books that lays to rest this cliché that books on wine should be pompous and stuffed to a fare thee well. Quite the reverse. This is very laid back, very smooth, frequently entertaining, often funny, and it features all the well-known names from Eric Asimov on down. The book itself is rather bland of jacket, anything but bland of content, and runs to several hundred pages long. But it runs the gamut, all types, all seasons, all approaches. The editor, Howard Goldberg, has taken chapters in chunks, whereby you have, for openers, the $410 corkscrew, and you have Wine Writing and Writers, The Jungle of Winespeak, What You Drink with What You Eat, and so on and so forth. But the actual anthologizing of this book, which must have been a labor of love, has resulted in a remarkable work that I think will stand the test of time. This is very much recommended. It is not something to read end to end, but as something to dabble in by the light of the silvery moon before you turn in for the night. It is a minor masterpiece. I recommend it warmly. I think it's going to fill a number of gaps in the Christmas list, and I think you'll find that it's on your shelf for a very long time to come. And on that Venus note,